afternoon. Welcome to the American Conservatives Value Network. I am your host, Akindele Akinyemi, and I'm glad to be here this afternoon with our good friend and my comrade, Charles Six, who is the founder and CEO of Ending Stereotypes for America. So what's going on?
All kinds of things are going on. A lot of great things are happening. First of all, for the audience who doesn't know what Ending Stereotypes for America is, it is a 501c3 nonprofit organization which uses history to disprove ethnic, racial, religious stereotypes and to show how all different ethnic groups have contributed to America to make it what it is today, the greatest country in probably world history. And I also talk about the contributions from people from all regions of the world. And what's going on? Lots of things are going on. First and foremost, recently we had some legislative success. For about 2.5 years now, I've been trying to get a bill passed that would ensure that the advanced kingdoms of Black Africa were taught in our schools.
Sure.
Because, you know, as you may know, you're recently from Africa, right? Sure. Second generation.
Well, a little bit about my background for the audience. My father's Nigerian.
Okay. Yeah.
And my mother is from Detroit, Michigan. So there's some Nigerian blood going through my veins. But I thank you. We all at some point all from Africa. So
yeah, I guess we are. Right. But you know, the stereotype is that Africa is, you know, all these primitive hunters and gatherers, all these savage people, no advanced civilization.
Sure.
The Zulu are the height of African civilization.
Right.
That's what most Americans believe.
Right.
And I saw how that affected my friends growing up because they were taught this in school.
Mm-hmm.
And they thought that Black people overall were incapable of creating an advanced civilization. Like Spain or England or, you know, China or the things you hear about in the Middle East. And so they would have these false stereotypes about Black people. And then consequently, they would also have a lot of stereotypes about other groups.
Sure.
So what I wanted to do, when I discovered that Africa had these advanced kingdoms in ancient and medieval times, many of them had, you know, their own currency. Three different Black African kingdoms developed their own written language.
Right.
You know, Arab, North African, Europeans would write about how some of these kingdoms, like Nubia, like in Ethiopia,
sure.
like Mali, Songhai, were some of the most advanced, most powerful kingdoms in the world. Yet
right.
you never hear about them. Ethiopia was building castles 1,000 years before Europe was building castles.
Right.
That's just a fact, but nobody knows about this. We think about these primitive
people. Why is this so? You're mentioning some of the importances of why we need to teach this.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I've been in education for over 10 years. And I'm an African American studies major from Eastern Michigan University.
Oh, okay.
I've studied Africana studies, which is the study of African civilizations.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm with you, but how do you feel? Let me ask this question as a 501c3. What do you think about, you have legislation that's passed.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think about teachers becoming certified in such a curriculum such as African history or African American studies? And the reason I'm asking that, Charles, is because oftentimes people ask me about how do you become certified in those types of multicultural studies, and unfortunately here in the state of Michigan, you cannot become certified in those multicultural studies. You have to be certified in whether it's history or some type of social science guidelines that are set by the State Board of Education and the Michigan Department of Education. You passed some legislation. You had success. Congratulations.
Yeah, now we should thank Mike Knopfs from Battle Creek, who was the main person spearheading it, and also Brenda Clack. She was the it was a bipartisan. Representative Mike Knopfs was a Republican. Brenda Clack was a Democrat who really got this legislation.
We like to thank Representative Knopfs out of Battle Creek, and also Representative Clack from the city of Flint for creating a bipartisan effort to make this bill bill become law and into reality.
Mm-hmm.
But I want to go deeper.
Mm-hmm.
We know that the struggle and the fight does not stop here.
Right.
We need to now make sure that this bill is enforced
mm-hmm.
into the school districts. I was getting at the certification piece, though, because oftentimes people come to me about how do you become certified in these things. Mm-hmm. You can't become certified. Is that something you're looking down the road at in terms of kind of pushing for certification?
You know, it would be great if a lot of these teachers had a greater expertise mm-hmm. in that area, because these teachers, you know, they'll go through it and they'll get their history degree. Yeah, when it comes to, you know, Africa, for instance, I mean, they don't know because they're not taught. You know, I had some very good history teachers in high school. Mm-hmm. I remember a teacher who, you know, showed us Malcolm X in the classroom and stuff like that, definitely wasn't a racist at all. Yet when he talked about the different regions of the world, I still remember him putting on the board all the different regions. And next to Europe, he had Spain, England, Rome, Greece. Mm-hmm. Next to Asia, China, Japan, the Mongol Empire. And then next to Africa, he put Bushmen and Pygmies.
Really?
Yes. Why? He didn't know any better. That's what he learned when he was in school. He didn't know any better. And it reinforced those false stereotypes. So yeah, it'd be great if we could have some more expertise in that area.
What about the critics that say, you know, I've been following this bill for quite some time, of course. What about some of the critics I hear? You know, Mr. Six shouldn't be going through the state legislative. Maybe he should have appealed to the State Board of Education or the Michigan Department of Education. This is more waste in government spending in terms of state spending on bills and stuff like this, trying to get this stuff enforced. What do you say to those critics?
Well, first of all, just getting the legislation passed, it created so much awareness. Mm-hmm. And so now that really did put a lot of people on alert, the Board of Education, the school boards. For instance, if I just came up to them on my own and said, hey, we need to get this African history stuff in there, everyone said, no, that's, you know, who are you?
Right.
Come and tell us this. But because we were able to build a broad amount of support, and at first, when we tried to get this passed, you know, we could only get about 20 co-sponsors. Because people, what is this fake African history talking about, you know, black people flying over pyramids? What are you talking about here?
Right.
And we had to go around with educate conservatives and liberals on the issue.
Okay.
And some of our biggest supporters became conservatives. And you talk about, you know, maybe you should have gone to a different step. But when you look at what the lawmakers have done in the past with education, you know, Algebra 2, requiring different kinds of, you know, physics and whatnot, it's the exact same thing. You know, you're just making sure that when African history is taught, we don't focus on the most primitive people. We focus on the advanced groups, just like every other region of the world. So it's actually just a very simple process.
Well, I of course I support this effort. One, you know, by me being Nigerian, and also, I'm American, Nigerian American. And I say that for a reason. This type of stuff is important, and the reason being is because the world, I mean, America, I mean, commerce. Things like this stuff is becoming global. Education, education is global. Mm-hmm. Economics is global.
Yep.
When you have folks like China, India, that are coming into the continent of Africa, and they are investing millions and millions of dollars in trades and goods, they understand the history, they understand the language, they understand understand what direction Africa is moving in, and I am a strong believer, Charles, in discussing not just the continent of Africa or ending stereotypes on the continent of Africa, but ending these stereotypes here in America, and also across what we know as the diaspora, where there is stereotypes that are going on in places like the Caribbean, South America, and places like Brazil. Brazil is one of the most diverse countries in the world with various different races and people and religions and even languages, even though the chief language there is Portuguese. Mm-hmm.